you. Well, thank you very much, Luke, for the invite, and thank you for coming. So, yeah, I'm going to talk today about Food Exeter as a sustainable food city, and just to give you an outline of my talk today. So the Sustainable Food Cities programme brings together civil society organisations working towards inclusive food networks and focus on promoting localised solutions to complex food and health issues. A number of authors, particularly Blaise Harmeritau 2018 and Mairead Fohan Sonino 2018, have investigated these processes as city-region food systems and translocal initiatives that can create transformative city-based food programmes. However, these initiatives, working as multi-stakeholder partnerships, involves navigating the conflicting agendas amongst partnership members who represent a range of interests, from boosting the local food economy, those addressing food poverty and issues of diet-related ill health. By lifting the lid on some of these processes, this talk explores sustainable food cities from the inside. I will explore how sustainable food cities operate as networks within a network, a process fueled by commitment, creativity, as well as an impetus to tackle complex food and health issues via partnership working. At the heart of the talk will be three case studies of networks within Food Exeter that are working from different positions to boost the local food economy, raise awareness of food and health, and provide a space for community access to good food. From the position of an activist scholar, this talk explores the potential for collective dynamism and transformation, as well as emerging contestations and conflicting agendas when working in multi-stakeholder partnerships. It will highlight the role of local, national, and translocal initiatives as devices working to bridge these conflicts and to provide a vehicle for collective action. Sustainable food city networks provide opportunities for divergent actors to work together to address local concerns. Through this activity, multi-stakeholder food partnerships increasingly act as an important link between food citizens and policymakers. By investigating the recent work of the city-based food partnership Food Exeter, including the development of key food programmes and strategy development, I will explore processes that work to foster understanding and shape more inclusive, localised food programmes. The Food Exeter case studies will highlight these processes and the impacts of internal and external initiatives that act as devices serving to bring together divergent actors. Drawing from the work of Tornaghi and Van Dyck 2015 and Boras 2016, I'll explore the work of Food Exeter from a scholar-activist perspective, which enables deeper understandings of issues that drive and hinder partnership development. Cities, it has been recognised, are ideally placed to promote localised food strategies and to join up divergent actors working towards similar ends. Recent scholarship has focused on the development of more effective food governance frameworks, such as in the global cities of London, Toronto, and New York, and translocal frameworks, such as the Milan Urban Food Policy Pact and the C40 Cities Network, who work for more just and sustainable policies. A more integrative approach to food policy thinking is being progressed via city-based initiatives that enable policymakers to work with civil society actors and translocal networks on common issues. Globalised and translocal networks of civil society food actors are emerging as coherent voices working to reconfigure the food system. In the UK since 2011, the Sustainable Food Cities Network has been engaging with localised food partnerships, taking steps towards transforming food cultures and food systems. The network has grown from the first six cities in 2015 to the 54 that are working today towards common goals of implementing and supporting sustainable food systems that meet the needs of local communities. With their urban basis, sustainable food cities have the potential to promote sustainable and healthy food by influencing policymakers, local communities and local businesses. City-based food partnerships bring together a wide range of actors with differing food and health perspectives, such as public health professionals, local food producers and retailers, and organisations working with food insecure communities. Partnership working has the potential to promote better understanding of localised food and health issues, as well as devising locally applicable solutions. Operating under a coalition of perspectives, sustainable food cities are working to build more inclusive and more locally attuned urban systems based on participative governance models. However, the processes and devices underpinning the development of successful partnerships require further exploration. This talk is based on activist scholarship research with Food Exeter, where I've been collaborating with a steering group for nearly two and working groups for nearly 2 years. In this process, I have been both a participant in and observer of the Food Network and its activities. This insider position enables me to engage closely with network personnel, assist in the process of network development, as well as reflect on how the intersection of other regional, national, and translocal initiatives can help to build the momentum of driving Food Exeter. During 2017, I led a feedback process on the then developing Exeter Food Strategy. For this, I co-convened a community workshop for the network where divergent voices could be heard. Elements of this strategy development will be discussed here, along with three case studies of Food Exeter's networks within networks. Food Exeter, formerly known as Exeter Food Network, a member of the Sustainable Food Cities Programme, has rapidly grown since 2015, from two partnership organisations to more than 24, including local farmers, retailers, chefs, public bodies, community-based NGOs, food activists, academics and nutritionists. It has set up occasional working groups and started an Exeter Summer Cookery School for school children to address issues of holiday hunger. The network promotes greater cooperation between local groups by running workshops and developing new skills. Through this journey of developing as a citywide organisation, Food Exeter has become a sustainable food city and works with other organisations such as Food Plymouth, Feeding Britain, People's Food Policy and Food Power. However, until recently, Food Exeter lacked funded support and still relies on members' own time to attend meetings, create resources and undertake work towards actions within or outside of their own working practices, alongside the support of a newly appointed coordinator. Several network organisations linked to steering group members are highly active in running city-based community programmes or commercial entities, such as Exeter Food Action, a food surplus redistributor, the nationally linked Sugar Smart campaign, Shilling Food Organics Vegbox Scheme and Veg Market, St Sidwell's city-based food and community hub and more. The activities of these grassroots organisations are able to influence steering group work by their history of embedded activity and influential personnel. However, other key local food civil society organisations and commercial entities such as West Town Farm are less influential due to their limited engagement with network processes. In 2017, the steering group led developing an Exeter food strategy in accord with Sustainable Food Cities defining principles. These mission statements cover issues of sustainable, healthy food, diet-related ill health, food poverty, community food knowledge, the local food economy, food waste and food procurement. West Town Farm is an organic livestock farm on the periphery of Exeter and produces much more than just food. West Town Farm is a micro network of organisations including Love Local Food and Organic Arts, who run land-based food education and arts programmes. The micro network brings together dynamic local food advocates delivering creative local food education programmes, as well as working towards extending food access in the city. The farm collaboration with Organic Arts utilises national schemes such as the Environmental Stewardship Scheme to run farm-based educational programmes. As Organic Arts highlight on their website, they offer 150 visits a year through the stewardship scheme, The farm has an incredible range of locations, including an old railway cutting, newly planted orchard, stream, meadows and woodland. The micro network is well embedded within Exeter local food networks, including other local food enterprises that are members of the Food Exeter Partnership. Together, they form a constituency of producers, consumers and retailers joined in their commitment to local food. Staff from Organic Arts are members of the Food Exeter Partnership. However, time and operational constraints mean they rarely attend meetings, and as such, their voice is less influential. In 2017, the farm hosted a workshop to provide a feedback process on Food Exeter's draft strategy and to explore members' challenges and resources in open discussions. The workshop aimed to strengthen the development of a supportive Exeter-based network working to further a vibrant and accessible local food culture. As the workshop was a private event for the network, discussion was able to take place in small groups, enabling a depth of discussion and engagement. Network members were invited to bring a poster outlining their priorities and shareable resources in an interactive session where workshop conveners matched challenges with shareable resources across the network. Introducing the session on strategy feedback, a steering group member stressed that the priority aims and action areas in the draft food strategy had been agreed within self-employed limits, such as focusing on achievable priorities and actions building from existing work and members' existing interests. Here's a box with actually the finalised food strategy priority aims. And the next one shows the action areas, which are seen as the main areas that the network is focused on. The open discussion provided insights into the challenges network members face when attempting to drive forward grassroots food action. Love Local's food, community food education programmes and mobile shop activities in Exeter's more deprived neighbourhoods were hit by the closure of community centres. The reduction in spaces for community food learning undermined Love Local Food's attempts to work across local food, food insecurity, and community health agendas. Once the community centre was closed, interest in local produce on their mobile shop plummeted. Feedback also highlighted concerns over links to local decision makers, notably Exeter City Council, who are seen by some as hindering local food producers and retailers' practices, such as parking charges for storeholders on market day. Food Exeter's members' everyday experiences of action to promote community food knowledge and food access highlight the challenges of working across local food, food insecurity agendas in a limited food policy environment. Workshop discussions brought to the fore tensions between members who are committed to local food production and consumption and those involved in programmes that address food insecurity. Partnership members who promote local food see alternative food networks as a means of providing high quality, fresh produce that can improve the biodiversity of productive agricultural land and boost the health of Exeter residents. Other partnership members see local food and AFNs as potentially exclusionary and ill-suited for programmes working to address food insecurity. Food Exeter's Sugar Smart campaign emerged from a very different constituency within the partnership, those drawn from public health and policy developments that seek to address diet-related ill health. A practitioner from Public Health Devon, along with other steering group members, led the launch of Sugar Smart Exeter in January 2017, with support and input from Exeter's Health and Wellbeing Board, University of Exeter Academics Working in Psychology, and Exeter City Council. Funding for Sugar Smart Exeter was awarded from the Sustainable Food Cities Sugar Smart campaign, with match funding sourced from a variety of bodies, including Exeter City Council. Sugar Smart is a locally run campaign based on a national framework with templates for pledges, branding and more. With a highly visible online communication strategy, the campaign has captured interest throughout Devon, with over 50 Devon-based organisations pledging to take action on sugar, such as reducing promotions on sugary food and drink and increasing the offer of healthy food choices. Sugar Smart Exeter has been seen as the trailblazer for the campaign in the Southwest and is currently supporting localised campaigns become established, such as Sugar Smart Tavistock that launched in March 2018. With the support of celebrity chefs such as Jamie Oliver, who initiated the national campaign, and Hugh Fleming-Whittingstall, who has highlighted issues of sugar consumption in his recent Britain's Fat Fight TV series, Sugar Smart is a highly visible campaign with influential local and national actors. It is seen as a dynamic and successful force within Food Exeter that serves to strengthen links to Food Plymouth, who have also been running their own Sugar Smart campaign. However, some Food Exeter partnership members see Sugar Smart as a separate, nationally coordinated program with limited links to the local food economy. In addition, time-limited funding, as the Sustainable Food Cities program attention now switches to their new Veg Cities campaign, may serve to limit its impacts. Working at a local and widely networked scale, St. Sibos Community Centre is a city-based space enabling practical local action. Housed within a repurposed 1950s church and on the edge of Exeter's commercial centre, St. Sidwell's is well resourced with its extensive green space, complete with historic tombs and a community vegetable garden that feeds the cafe. Inside there are many community resources, including meeting rooms, a large community cafe and well-equipped kitchen. Much of the activity at St. Sidwell's centres on empowering people through food, from weekly food growing and cooking training sessions, including bread and preserves making, to themed cultural food events. St. Sidwell's have been instrumental in setting up and running Food Exeter's Holiday Hunger Schools Cooking Club programme that began in 2015. This flagship Food Exeter programme continues to support children at risk of holiday hunger in the local school, in the long school summer holidays. It draws together influential actors from across the Food Exeter partnership, including veteran politicians, public health practitioners, and those rescuing and redistributing edible food. St. Sidwell's also acts as the venue for some of Food Exeter's meetings and partnership events, providing a space for network information sharing, updates from the steering group, and opportunities for collaborating on joint projects and funding bid. St. Sidwell's projects are locally focused and deploy local skills and knowledge to boost Food Exeter's culture. Local food environment and issues and address issues of food insecurity via accessible programmes. The manager of St. Sidwell's, along with key members of the Food Exeter steering group, have a long history of collaborating on projects and together retain a wealth of knowledge of local food action in the city over many years. The in-place knowledge within Food Exeter is complemented by linkages to national programmes and campaigns on complex food issues, including holiday hunger and food insecurity, such as Frankfield MP's Holiday Hunger, Meals and Activities Bill. These wider programmes help give some stability to local food work that is often overly reliant on key personnel and scarce resources. These wider initiatives, including the current Food Power funded food poverty campaign, assist in linking up diverging agendas within the network. Currently, Food Exeter is linked to external national and regional bodies that influences actions, direction and programmes of work. It has strong internal links to grassroots organisations and community groups within Exeter that shape its knowledge of the city's food and health needs. These diverse links provide a foundation for activities going forward. In particular, engagement with neighbouring Food City Food Plymouth, the Sustainable Food Cities and Food Power programmes, coupled with links to central decision-making bodies such as Public Health Devon, assist in developing Food Exeter's potential outward reach. The diversity of experience within the membership, both in the wider network and steering group, is critical to its ability to understand the lived food experiences directly affecting communities in Exeter. This diversity of experience also highlights the differing constituencies or networks within the network from which Food Exeter is comprised. Due to these differing standpoints, There is no surprise that there are often differing opinions on decisions and actions. The process of strategy formation and other subgroup campaigns highlighted conflicting agendas in the steering group. There is a disconnect between the ideals and activities of food extra organisations, particularly between those advocating for stronger local food systems and those concerned with issues of food insecurity and diet-related ill health. The grassroots creative resilience activities taking place within Sustainable Food Cities networks form a heart of gradual change, or as Nisi Owen et al. Call it, quietly radical action. However, some of this inspiring work, such as that taking place at the micro network Westtown Farm, happens at a remove to core food city decision making. Finding ways to boost communication and engagement from the physical and operational heart of Food Extra to its periphery would help develop stronger and more active connections.
Sorry, can you say that again?
Okay. Finding ways to boost communication and engagement from the physical and operational heart of Food Exeter to its periphery would help develop stronger and more active connections. These disconnects are compounded by the complexity of globally networked agri-food systems that have limited governance constraints put on them, along with the partnership's lack of long-term financial sustainability. Newly secured funding for a network coordinator and progressing work identified within action areas has the potential to disrupt some of these disconnects. Current priorities, such as developing a food poverty plan, has the potential to create impetus and activity that unites agendas focused on promoting healthy food consumption and developing local food systems. Certain elements of the network, such as St. Sidwell's Community Centre, act as more than a physical food hub for Exeter. With its ability to bring together people to work across diverging agendas, St. Sidwell's also acts as a central node, linking people with commitment and passion to work together for food change via practical food action. Working as a scholar activist frames my relationship with Food Exeter in that I prioritise listening and reflecting on the situated experiences of community group members who work directly in food and community projects in the city. In the early days of my activity, I certainly took time to find a role following Tornaghi and Van Dyck's suggestion to develop a sense of being in the movement. As is common in organisations reliant on volunteers, sustainable food city committees can become dominated by those with time to give rather than those with the deepest experience or expertise. Steering group personnel are subject to change, creating precarity for the partnership. As an early career academic, my input to Food Exeter is also precarious, being based on access to funding, research contracts, and available time to offer. As Boras 2016 states, working as an activist requires commitment and passion in order to affect change. Passion and commitment link steering group members and underpin communication processes, the sharing of understandings, and a willingness to work together, albeit within members' time constraints. Working collaboratively with city-based food networks, food scholar activists with their international links can also act as devices for knowledge co-production and assist in generating awareness of international and translocal food governance initiatives that are commonly founded on a commitment to act for food change. The Food Exeter Partnership operates as a situated network of organisations joining together civil society organisations, food enterprises, with some links to local policymakers. Through its internal and external connections, it has national linkages that provide the potential to learn from best practices elsewhere. However, due to limited funded support, its work is precarious and reliant on the goodwill of those given their time to attend meetings and complete actions. This precarity impacts the reach of its communications, both within the network and wider community. National campaigns and funding opportunities, deliberative processes such as the strategy feedback workshop, along with accessible spaces for everyday practical food action that take place at St. Sidwell's, supports participatory processes underpinning Food Exeter. Everyday food and health campaigns along with innovative food programmes, act as devices to link network members and communicate their actions to wider publics. Strategy development and the identifying of key priority areas have deepened internal network connections, such as Food Exeter's subgroup work on local food markets and the Food Poverty Action Plan. It has also strengthened external contacts with Food Plymouth and provided momentum to apply for funds to support its work going forward. Fostering opportunities for learning by doing, that is, developing deeper understandings across competing agendas by unified action towards common goals, can assist in joining up divergent actors in city-based food networks. The case studies discussed illustrate both the tensions and potential within city-based food partnerships, with food actors implementing innovative programmes to engage a wide range of communities. Mechanisms to support networks within a network and foster understanding across differing food issues can lay the foundation for potentially transformative food action. City-based sustainable food networks with a clear identity can help encourage city-based food policy change. Cohesive city food networks can boost the visibility of regional local food producers, community food programmes, and generate integrated practices across organisations promoting healthier, sustainable food consumption. Network approaches to experimental food programmes do create tensions, in particular between competing local food and health and food insecurity agendas. By fostering dialogue and joining up community-based programmes, food city networks can generate mutual understanding between network members working together for food change.